Everybody, welcome back to the show. Now, if you're an ardent viewer of our program, and for commercial purposes, we certainly hope that you are, you may recall last year that we did an interview with Monty Mesa. You may know him from being the general manager of the Guam Premier Outlets. And we were talking about the Guam Nikkei Association, which is an organization that seeks to find information about people that came from Japan to Guam in the late 1800s and the early 1900s. Monty joins me once again. And Monty, Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you, too. And again, Happy New Year to everybody on Guam.
Okay, so we're going to do an update on this and then also talk about some of the work that goes on from this point with the Guam Nikkei Association. So how has the registration, as it were, been since we first talked last year?
Well, we've had an increase from 6 names to now 11 names of Japanese families who submitted their grandfather or uncle's names to the association in recognition of their relationship with Guam during the early 1900s. Mm. And we are looking for those families, maybe a granddaughter or great-granddaughter who hasn't carried the Japanese name, and married into a different name, but still has a Japanese name and has their great-grandfather's name that we want to recognize who's been here in the late 1800s or early 1900s, and even prior to World War II when it broke out, 70 years ago, we're celebrating the liberation of 70 years mm-hmm. of liberation from the Japanese occupation. We wanted to pay tribute to those Japanese who have not been duly recognized, but also we lost track, either they died and was not accounted for. And we wanted to pay tribute in acknowledging them and erecting a monument up in Jigo at the Peace Memorial Park. Mm-hmm. We are so happy that the South Pacific Peace Foundation allowed us to erect a monument to again recognize those Japanese men and women who were here prior to the war, who made Guam their home, married into the Chamorro women families and Chamorro men, and perished either before the war or during the war and weren't accounted for. So this is one way that the Guam Nikkei Association, would like to pay tribute and recognize and have this monument in recognition for those that weren't accounted for.
Now, I'm sure conventional wisdom might dictate that they say, okay, well, 6 to 11 names have been submitted. On paper, that doesn't seem like a lot, but I mean, we're talking about, the latter part of the 1800s, so you're talking about people tracing their lineage for maybe 160 years right now. But even with that small number, are you still able to take the names submitted on a case-by-case basis and actually do a lot more work and say, like, okay, we can maybe map and, actually find out who these people were, maybe a lot more so than if, you'd had 80, 90, 100 names?
Absolutely. Some of the families have some documents and relating to how their great-grandfather or uncle or aunt that was here. And one registry that we've used, and it's very good that in the early 1900s, any Japanese man who married a Chamorro woman, of course, had to be converted to Catholicism. Mm-hmm. And the church kept very good records of all these men, Japanese names, marrying the Chamorro women and registered them and have a listing. And we're going by that list as well. And if families that know their grandfather's name and grandmother, they could also look at that list and see if that is their lineage to the Japanese name with that family. And we could use those names in recognition of their particular family name.
Mm-hmm. Now, what work lay ahead as far as what you're trying to do? Obviously, you want to get more people to submit names, and you want more people to kind of do research and figure out, I have, maybe my grandfather, great-grandfather, great-great-grandfather, if it goes that far back, and get in touch with you guys. But what's the next step? Where do you go from here?
Well, our aim this year, again, in recognition for the 70 years of Guam liberation, we wanted to put a deadline in submitting or suggesting these names up to the end of this month, January 31st, because we would want to have finalized an architectural design of the plaque that would pay tribute to these names of Japanese men and women. But also working with contractors to develop this. So we want to hopefully get this monument put in place with a ceremony up at the Jigo Peace Memorial Park by July to commemorate the 70 years of liberation for Guam. Mm-hmm. And we have a short timeline to, again, make sure that the research is done properly for these names. And hopefully by the end of January 31st, we'll have those suggested names so that we can, again, validate all of it and ensure that they are included and be recognized for it.
All right, before we let you go, how can people get in touch with you to find out more information?
Yes, they can get in touch with me by email, monty@guam.net, or they can call my cell phone at 888-1944. Mm-hmm. They also can call our past president, Peter Onadera. You can reach him at peteronadera@gmail.com.
All right, excellent. Monty, thanks so much again.
Thank you.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Always good to see you.
You too.
All right, stay tuned. We're back after this.